Let's now welcome Jens Dornhege, Technical Specialist for EPAS Features and Functions at Ford Vehicle GmbH. In his presentation, Jens will discuss how the use of driving simulators in the development of ADAS algorithms helps reduce physical prototypes and development time. The stage is yours, Jens.
Thanks for the nice introduction. Let me start with a short introduction who we as a team are. We're working in the range of vehicle controls, especially on the electric power steering. Within that, we do function development, but that doesn't contain the basic assist function or the basic software of the control module. What we do is disturbance rejection features. Like you might know, with an imbalance on the wheel, we counteract the vibration in the steering wheel actively with the EPAS motor, for example. I would like to take you to this presentation on the example of a lane keeping system. That's our other part, that we enable the ADAS features with the respective steering functions. But next to the function development of those features, we also do the software coding in our team. Means we start with Simulink and move over, adopt that to C code, which is compiled in our team and sent as an object to the supplier who integrates the functions. This keeps our IP in-house and additionally allows us to reuse the functions vehicle line after vehicle line to have everywhere the same code. Next to those two parts, as we know the features best, we are also responsible for vehicle application, calibration, and testing. Let me jump now to the function development. The task of a lane-keeping system is, in case you detect unintended lane departure, to really smoothly and gently steer back into your lane and align the vehicle in parallel to the driving lane. But during function development, errors might happen and faults might happen in the system, what in case of an EPAS system leads to deviation of your path. And believe me, the steering system is stronger than you as a driver, and this has to be absolutely avoided. This means in function development, before we can bring a function to the road, we really require extensive testing, what takes time and doesn't ease up your development cycles. Similar issues we have with vehicle application calibration and testing. Our customers don't expect a lane-keeping function working on a straight. They also expect working in turns and usually in each and every situation. And unfortunately, our proving grounds are limited. We can't provide all the scenarios we need to test. Result of that is that we need to go for public road testing to find all the scenarios we intend to do. The issue with that is, again, the extended testing required and also the travel time. So we have a list of scenarios in our environment of our development center where we know they are critical, but sometimes it's an hour of travel time or driving time to get there for a bit of testing and then you return for an hour. And this travel time and the testing really complicate a comprehensive validation. So we thought about attributes of our evaluation and test tasks. And I would like to compare the vehicle test to the offline simulation. And finally, in that discussion, we put a DIL simulator in the middle. When you look at these attributes, I can't go through them in detail. You see many bars which range from green to red, but some in opposite direction. But we found that for many of those cases, the dill simulator in the center has pretty good shape. And that led to our conclusion that the dill simulator would be really a good bridge to combine vehicle testing with the offline CRE simulation and come to the point. But to get useful results out of the dill together with the offline simulation, it's mandatory from my point of view to have a continuous tool chain between both. So meaning the offline simulation must use the same model as the dill simulator. Must be same rest bus simulation, same vehicle model, same calibration for both. And another conclusion we have drawn from this investigation was, whenever you have a clear maneuver definition and you have clear metrics in your post-processing, where you come to results from evaluating the numbers, do it offline. Don't waste your simulator time, which is more valuable for the subjective evaluation, from my point of view. Let me sketch the simplified setup in the simulator we use for the lane keeping development and calibration. Of course, it's a VR-grade environment that we purchased after this investigation. We have a static simulator because that's, from our point of view, the perfect match or perfect compromise between cost and efficiency for our use case, which means driving up to 0.3 G with really smooth steering movement only. Within this environment, we run the vehicle model, and I've been talking about the continuous tool chain. We have to support CarSim for the project with the vehicle dynamics guys. We have to support IPG CarMaker to work together with the ADAS team, and we're still running VIKA real-time with the projects we started with that. So connected to the vehicle model is, of course, a mock-up to host the driver and get the inputs. We have an AF Pro environment for the graphics, as our US colleagues already had a simulator running for years and have spent money to digitalize our proving grounds in that system. To get good results in the steering environment, we pulled out the steering system as an external model completely. And for that to work well, we also require a rest bus simulation, which sounds as an easy task in the beginning, but really gets complicated because all the modules in the vehicle have to interact and talk together. There are handshakes involved. And that takes a lot of time to get that resolved. I said we put special emphasis on the steering in our dill simulator. And that's mainly two requirements we've seen there. The first is, of course, to provide precise torque feedback to the driver. So with the system we have currently, the vehicle dynamics steering evaluators told us it really feels like a vehicle steering as long as you don't steer too hard. So our use case of up to 0.3 G is supported there, and if you don't steer too fast. But we believe that we are in pretty good shape there. Second requirement is to provide precise vehicle reaction to the feature torque requests. Of course, when we calibrate the lane-keeping system, the vehicle reaction must be as it is in reality. So in that external steering model, we of course have to model the mechanical system, compromised of few masses connected by springs, as it's usually done. But the key there is to add the useful and correct friction models to the right points. In our case, we receive this mechanical model from the supplier, who has really given great input there from part measurements to come to a good mechanical system. Of course, the electromechanical components, like the motor for the torque assist, have to be modeled well as some sensor with their discretization and time steps, whatever it takes. And last but not least, the software is important. In our case, as said, we rely for the basic assist on the supplier software, and the supplier really delivers an S function to us as it is in the vehicle. This S function also contains the identified or specified interface to our Ford features, which we deliver as our own code. Next point I want to stress are the specialized tracks. I said that we are looking for special situations and we don't find them on the proving grounds. In this case, or for this case, we have developed some tracks, but as they are used from professional drivers, we didn't really do fancy graphics. It's just the definition of the track with straights and curves as the calibrator asked for. So we have been in discussion, what would you like as a track to calibrate the function? And clearly comes down to the breakpoints of the calibration values for the radius, and we have been able to fulfill the need. So as said, used by professional drivers, those tracks are rather simple from the graphics. We just put some trees to the side of the road to improve the speed impression. But as you might see here, we have on the left-hand side the lane marking very close to the grass. On the right-hand side, there's a strip of tarmac, and there the calibrator can distinguish or choose whether he wants a normal intervention or increased road edge intervention. These tracks are created by parametrized scripts. And that has the advantage whenever the calibrator asks during a session for a different situation, he wants to do something special. He asks for 273 meters radius with 15% lateral road slope, for example. It's created on demand as he fills his mug with coffee. So it's only a few minutes until the track is available. And different to the proving ground, where you might find the right cornering situation, do your test and then have to drive a complete lap to come to that same radius again. We have created a track, or many tracks, with the correct radius one after the other. So really allowing continuous testing without all these break times. Next very important thing, I've talked about a continuous tool chain in the simulation, but the same applies to the calibrator. Our calibrators are used to canopy from a vector to do the calibration. You see the screen here a bit blurred, because I neither want to discuss our variable naming convention with you, nor the actual calibration we use. But Canopy requires to communicate to an XCP server, which is usually inside the embedded module. In our case at the simulator, we needed to provide an XCP server, which wasn't really an easy task, to find the correct thing and integrate it into the environment. But we managed to find one, and this XCP server is running on a separate computer communicating via UDP with the SIM workbench environment. And the setup allows now for the calibrator to use his known, well-known layouts, where he really knows which variable is in which place. You've seen this one page of the layout, but for lane keeping calibration, they use 12 of these pages. And they really need to feel at home to do their work efficiently. And not only the layouts are 100% compatible to the vehicle, but also the parameterization files. So Calibrator is able to do the parameterization inside the simulator, save the PAR file as it is in the simulator, send it via email to his colleague on the proving ground who continues to work in vehicle directly at that point. And vice versa, of course. So it's very clear. Oh, let me end this presentation a bit in comic style. The DIL simulator has enabled us to really do efficient LKS calibration even before the prototypes were available. I had hoped that the prototypes arrived within this week and I could give now feedback how the calibration from the simulator did work out in vehicle. But unfortunately, those prototypes are late, as always. But this time, we have a calibration for the delayed prototypes, and they are not there. Second point I would like to mention here is we have now the function development really in short cycles. All the risk involved with a new function in a steering system is gone. We didn't take the risk before, but we got rid of all this intermediate testing which is required. A third point is that the simulator and using these methods on the simulator enables us to share our results with other regions having access to a simulator as well. You know, a colleague of mine has developed a new functionality, a new idea of a function, wanted to transport this to a US colleague, and they have used different rapid controls prototyping vehicles for that. And what has worked in a Ford Focus didn't work out in a Lincoln MKS. Absolutely different functionality, so even the ID has not been transported well. Using the simulators, and fortunately our US colleagues own VI-grade simulators as well, we will be able to transfer those IDs now. Of course, all the stuff didn't come from me. There's our European team working on that. I've listed the names of our European core team, but thanks go not only to them, but also to our US simulator team, where we are really in good exchange of ideas and solutions, and additionally many, many more in our company, providing all those vehicle models to us, providing the S functions for the RESPA simulation, and many, many more.